We're going to see how Taylor series can help us solve some problems that we've seen previously that might have been more difficult to solve. Let's start by looking at the limit as x goes to 0 of 2x squared plus cosine of 2x minus 1 over x to the fourth. Note that if we were to plug in 0, the top would go to 0 plus 1 minus 1, which would be 0, and the bottom would go to 0. So we would have a 0 over 0 indeterminate form. Now we could do L'Hopital's rule, but let's try instead looking at the Taylor series for cosine of 2x. So we could rewrite this as the limit as x goes to 0 of 2x squared plus, now cosine of 2x, we know the Taylor series for cosine of x. It's 1 minus x squared over 2 factorial plus x over to the fourth over 4 factorial minus x to the sixth over 6 factorial plus dot dot dot. It goes on and on like that, right? But now it's cosine of 2x, so we're going to put a 2x in each of those spots where the x would go. And then, so that's our cosine of 2x, and then we do minus 1 divided by x to the fourth. And what can we say then? Well, we have a plus 1 here and a minus 1 here, so we can add those together and get 0. And we also have a 2x squared here, and we have a term here that's an x squared. So let's think about what that's going to simplify to. That's going to simplify to 4, 2 squared, x squared over 2 factorial, which is 2. So this is going to simplify to 2x squared. So these two terms are going to add to 0, and we're going to be left with the limit as x goes to 0 of 2x to the fourth over 4 factorial minus 2x to the sixth over 6 factorial plus 2x to the eighth over 8 factorial plus dot 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 over x to the fourth. But now we can divide everything through by 1 over x to the fourth, or maybe factor out an x to the fourth on top might be easier. Let's try that. So let's do limit as x goes to 0, and let's pull out an x to the fourth. So now we're looking at 2 to the fourth over 4 factorial minus 2 to the sixth x squared over 6 factorial plus 2 to the eighth x to the fourth over 8 factorial, etc., over x to the fourth on the bottom. Now, canceling this x to the fourth because the number over itself is 1, we are left with looking at the limit as x goes to 0 of 2 to the fourth over 4 factorial plus 2 to the sixth x squared over 6 factorial plus 2 to the eighth x to the fourth over 8 factorial plus dot 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 dot. And know that this term is multiplied by x squared, so it's going to go to 0. This term is multiplied by x to the fourth, it's going to go to 0. And all these other remaining terms at the end are also all going to go to 0 because they have powers of x in them. And the only thing that's going to be left is that 2 to the fourth over 4 factorial, which is 16 over 24 or 2/3. So this gives us a way of finding a complicated looking limit, and it gives us some intuition because we kind of get an idea of what power of x the top acts like and what power of x the bottom acts like, and thus what should happen. Let's try another limit example. We have the limit as x goes to 2 of natural log of x minus 1 minus x plus 2 over x minus 2 squared. Now let's look at what would happen to this if we plug in. We have natural log of 2 minus 1, so natural log of 1, which is 0, minus 2 plus 2, so this is a 0 altogether. And on the bottom, we have 0 squared, so that's a 0. So this is again the indeterminate form 0 over 0. So we could try to do L'Hopital's rule, but let's try this Taylor series method again. So do we know a Taylor series for natural log of x minus 1, which includes x equals 2 in the interval of convergence? Well, we could rewrite this as the natural log of 1 plus x minus 2, which would be the natural log of 1 plus u for some u. And we know the power series for that. That's u minus u squared over 2 plus u cubed over 3 minus u to the fourth over 4 plus dot dot dot. And so we can say that the natural log of x minus 1 equals the natural log of 1 plus x minus 2, which is equal to x minus 2 minus x minus 2 squared over 2 plus x minus 2 cubed over 3 minus x minus 2 to the fourth over 4 plus dot dot dot. And what do we know about the interval of convergence? Well, the interval of convergence for this natural log of 1 plus u is negative 1 less than u less than or equal to 1. So we would have, for our series here, negative 1 less than x minus 2 less than or equal to 1, which means that 1 is less than x less than or equal to 3. So yes, 2 is in there. All right, so let's try doing our limit this way then. So we're looking at the limit as x goes to 2 of, well, we have this series here, right? So x minus 2 minus x minus 2 squared over 2 plus x minus 2 cubed over 3 minus x minus 2 to the fourth over 4 plus dot dot dot, and then minus x plus 2 all over x minus 2 squared. So note that the negative x plus 2 at the end here can be rewritten as negative x minus 2. So we have a positive x minus 2 and a negative x minus 2. So those are going to go away. And we're going to be left with the limit as x goes to 2 of negative x minus 2 squared over 2 plus x minus 2 cubed over 3 minus x minus 2 to the fourth over 4 plus dot 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 over x minus 2 squared. Now let's pull out an x minus 2 squared out of the top. Or maybe this time let's divide everything through by x minus 2 squared. Let's just see how it looks different that way. So we're going to multiply top and bottom over 1 minus over x minus 2 squared. This is really the same algebra trick. And so we get on top negative 1/2 plus x minus 2 to the first over 3 minus x minus 2 squared over 4 plus dot dot dot, terms that have higher powers of x minus 2 in it, all over 1 in the bottom. So what's going to happen? This term is going to go to 0 as x goes to 2. This term is going to go to 0 as x goes to 2. And all these other terms have powers of x minus 2 in them, so they're also going to go to 0. So the only thing that's going to be left is going to be the negative 1/2 over 1, which is negative 1/2. Again, you could check this answer with L'Hopital's rule. It will also work on this problem. Now let's look at the problem. The limit as x goes to infinity, x times e to the 2 over x minus 1. So the x is going to infinity, and e to the 2 over x, that's going to go to e to the 0, which is 1. So 1 minus 1, that's 0. So this is infinity times 0. That's another indeterminate form. And again, we could do this with L'Hopital's rule. It's a little more painful when it's infinity times 0. But let's again see if we can use Taylor series to solve this problem. So can we find a series for e to the 2 over x? Well, we know a series for e to the x, right? So let's try putting 2 over x into it. So we have 1 plus 2 over x over 1 factorial plus 2 over x squared over 2 factorial plus dot dot dot. Now, are we allowed to do that? This is not a power series. We can't have x's on the bottom. These are going to have negative powers of x, so it's definitely not a power series. But it does turn out it's going to work. We do have to worry about one thing, though. We're doing a substitution here. We're letting u equal 2 over x, and we're using the e to the u formula, right? So when x is going to infinity, then u here would be going to 0 from the right side. So instead of taking the limit as x goes to infinity, if we're going to instead look at this new series in terms of u, we want to look at the limit as u goes to 0 from the right and then actually write our problem in terms of u. So let's try this. This is going to be the limit as u goes to 0 from the right of 1 plus u over 1 factorial plus u squared over 2 factorial. Now it's a power series, right? Plus dot dot dot. Now that's the e to the 2x part. Maybe we should write our original problem in u's before we try to plug the series in. So let's write our original problem in terms of u. So we want to take the limit as u goes to 0 from the right of, well, if u is 2 over x, that tells us that x is 2 over u. So we're going to get 2 over u for that x here in the front. And then we have e to the u minus 1. So now we can use power series. So we're doing the limit as u goes to 0 from the right of 2 over u times, and then we have 1 plus u plus u squared over 2 factorial plus u cubed over 3 factorial plus dot dot dot. And then we have minus 1, and this whole thing was in parentheses. Okay, so now again we have a 1 in the front and a negative 1 at the end. So we're going to be able to cancel those. And so we're going to be looking at limit as u goes to 0 from the right of 2 over u times u plus u squared over 2 factorial plus u cubed over 3 factorial. And you can see in all the problems where this is actually going to work, all of the terms at the end of the Taylor series, that tail, are always going to go to 0. Let's go ahead and factor this 2 over u through. So limit as u goes to 0 from the right, we're going to get 2 over u times u is 2, plus 2 over u times u squared over 2 factorial is u, plus 2 u squared over 3 factorial, plus 2 u cubed over 4 factorial, plus dot 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 dot. And when we take this limit now, we're going to keep the 2, and everything else is going to go to 0. So we get an answer to our limit of 2.